Mr. Bingley.
Is he an officer? Is he a scholar?
I testify to nothing, but that he brings in $5,000 a year, and that he will attend the Long's Ball this Tuesday.
$5,000 a year? Oh, Mr. Bennett, how are you? Oh, Mr. Bennett!
Oh, no. I hope I brought a moment's peace. Now, Mary, cough as much as you like.
I reach back to him. James, whatever shall you do to get him into your clutches?
Me? Do I have you?
Me? No. You shall have to be the one to follow Mr. Bingley's role. Sword? He quick about it too. The clock is ticking for us old maid.
Well, then why shouldn't I catch him?
Or me? Well, Lydia, you're much too young to think of such things, and Mary, you're. And Mary.
How do you know once you found the right match?
Well, it's complicated, dear, but I imagine you know we met the right one. There's a simple understanding between souls, wordless and faultless.
Well, one of you will have to marry to save the family from ruin because I will have none of it.
Oh, you don't mean that. I know myself, Jane, and I shall never marry.
I would. However, I'm going to love a lady on, so do hurry and make a proper arrangement with Mr. Come.
Jane, Lizzie, and Mama,
Lydia.
I have done my duty. see fire.
No.
Elizabeth here, while I go fetch Mr. Bennett.
Mr. Wickham, I have a naughty proposition for you. I demand that you come to stories to the biggest ball this season, Lydia.
Shh. I know Jane will be so sure.
Lizzie is very available. Aren't you, Lizzie?
Oh, Lydia. Do excuse my sister.
Miss Elizabeth, the Darcy your sister mentioned, is that Mr. Darcy of Derbyshire?
The same. Mr. Wickham, I will tell you that I find that man very disagreeable.
Mr. Darcy's father was my godfather, and he promised me that when I came to manhood, I would inherit a most valuable thing. But I'm afraid that after he died...
You were robbed of your inheritance, Mr. Darcy?
I have sworn to never speak ill of him in memory of my beloved godfather.
Mr. Bennett will be presently.
I really must be on my way, ma'am. I only want to escort the little girls home safely. Miss Lizzie, I do hope to see you at the ball.
What a charming man. Well, Lizzie, isn't he perfect?
What a catch. I'm not interested in catching anyone, and you shouldn't be thinking such matters.
But that's all anybody thinks of.
Not me.
Well, you want to.
Where is this Paris?
He doesn't miss it, Papa.
Well, then I have fulfilled my duty as Patreon, frightening off unserious young men. Ooh, but I've had quite the letter. I hope you can accommodate another young man for dinner, madam.
Mr. Bingley?
No, my dear. It is my cousin, Mr. Collins. He is the same villain who shall inherit this estate when I am dead and at less peace.
Oh, I tell you, ladies, I am sent by the most righteous Lady Catherine de Bourgh. Lady Catherine de Bourgh?
Hello.
I flatter myself that my overtures are commendable and that you'll not spurn this olive branch. Fair cousins, madam, shall be to feel forever entranced. I hope the couple was all of my cousins in the course of this evening. I may make this a claim to you. I think I am the most determined to heal a rift between our households. To be plain, I'm a bachelor, and thanks to my noble patroness, Lady Catherine de Bourgh, I am a man of considerable fortune.
Mr. Collins.
Your eldest daughter.
Jane
is excessively pretty.
I must inform you that Jane is spoken for, but the rest of my daughters are quite available.
I'm sent to bring you dinner, sir.
Oh, for you, my sweet cousin.
Understanding that you possess no defects whatsoever.
Miss Bennett,
I'm not perfect. I have some faults. Perhaps my temper's a little too unyielding for the world, and my good opinion, once lost, is lost for good.
Your defect is, I'm afraid, a desire to hate everyone.
And yours is to willfully misunderstand him.
Mr. Darcy, I could have sworn that you would have slithered back to town by now. By all means, do not tarry.
Why are you here, sir? For you know that nobody likes you. And why are you dancing with Lizzie? For we know that you do not like her. Let's go find Wickham for you.
Mr. George Wickham of Derbyshire.
Thank you.
disappoint you.
How many times must I tell you? Tell everyone that I shall never marry.
I traveled early to avoid the bad weather, ma'am.
We are only too pleased, except Ed and I are dressed for company of brothers. My nephew, Mr. Fitzwilliam Darcy.
I'm surprised to find you in kit, Miss Bennet.
Well, it seems I cannot escape you, and vice versa. Might I inquire after Mr. Bingley?
I left Bingley in town.
He left Mary from suddenly. All of them.
And were we missed? In vain, I have struggled. My feelings shall no longer be repressed. Let me admire and love you. I love you. In spite of my endeavors, in spite of the unsuitability of the match, and of your family, and quite frankly, your own conduct, you have ensnared me, Miss Bennet. You win.
I am so far from trying to ensnare you, Mr. Darcy, that I've openly decreed you as the most uncivil of men. And you reproach me for my behavior or your treatment of Mr. Wickham.
Perhaps Wickham didn't tell you what led to his disinheritance. He tried to seduce my sister. Georgiana was only 14 years old. As to your sister, I could tell Jane of Bingley, like Jane Bennet. However, she didn't invite a serious attachment.
And you're blind.
What I did see was a perfect match.
From the very moment of my acquaintance with you, you have been unfailingly arrogant and prideful and disdainful of the feelings of others, especially my sister Jane.
Miss Bennet, I swear I shall never express sentiments so disgusting again.
Shall you come to dinner?
My lady, do you know Mr. Wickham?
The tennis player
is a cyber call.
You have
horses
in the
Marshall
Channel.
Lizzie, Charlotte, what's wrong?
A dreadful letter from your father.
I told him I was open.
It appears that your sister, Miss Lydia, has run away with Mr. Wickham.
I shall restore to you.
No. No, please don't report me.
Thank you. closet. Lydia? The short one? I was in there at least an hour. Recovering nicely.
Mary!
No, yes, but no! We laugh and stop the world.
Pardon?
I don't understand you! You do all these perfectly honorable deeds, sir. And you say all these beautiful things. But then, but then, both you do things, well, you act in a very appalling manner. And I myself am sorry for several, many, not all, but some things. And I don't want to be ruined, and I don't want you to be the laughing stock of the world, so just leave. Now, please.
Lizzie, let them laugh.